Hey there, folks. Lenny Ruto here for BoatUS Magazine. You know, we're going to talk handheld VHFs today. And we've come to the West Marine in Hillsmere, Maryland, because there's a nice wide selection of handhelds here. Now, naturally, they don't have every one made by every brand. But what we do see is three pretty distinct categories of handheld VHFs. Now, first thing I want to point out, these days, these units are much more advanced than they used to be. 10, 15 years ago, there was a much bigger spread in the quality. These days, all of these are waterproof. All of these have rechargeable lithium-ion batteries. Two big points that are really, really good for you and me. Now, let's look at some of the differences. Here is your bottom line lowest cost unit. It costs about $100. It's still IPX rated 7, which is pretty darn good. It has 5 watts of power, which all do with a few exceptions. Some go to 6. But the truth of the matter is the power coming out of a handheld isn't such a huge deal. You're more going to be limited by antenna height than anything else. So most you can get is a couple few miles of range with these units, so it's not a massive factor. Now, what happens if you step up a level? Let's take a look. Here we have a model that's kind of a step up. It costs about $60 more. What does that get you? Well, for starters, this one's IPX rating is 8 as opposed to 7. 7 is submersible down to a meter for up to 30 minutes, whereas an IPX8 unit can actually be submerged deeper than a meter and still keep its seal. This one also has a 12-hour battery life as opposed to a 10-hour battery life in the less expensive model. And although these two units weigh about the same, you will find some of the higher-priced handheld VHFs that are significantly lighter. That's often a sign of quality as they take some of the weight out and it can be a little more comfortable in hand. Now here we have one of the most expensive units in this entire display. This one goes for about $230, but it has a big advantage over these other units. This one has an integrated GPS, it has an LCD screen. Some of these even allow for some navigation, but more importantly, it has DSC. You've got the panic button right there. Which one of these handheld VHFs belongs in your ditch bag? Well, that's a call that only you can make, but now you know the major differences between these different categories of units. And of course, there are other features that different units have that may be more attractive to you or less attractive to others. Some have built-in strobes. Some have noise-canceling features that make it easier to hear or to be heard more clearly. Check them all out and make your own decision. Well, folks, we hope this video has been helpful, and we hope you'll comment in the box below. Don't forget, subscribe to the BoatUS YouTube channel and check out our videos in the future.